G'day all, Mr. Paladin here, and today I want to take a look at some game sense, starting with the map Payload Upward. In particular, let's go into detail about the area before the first capture point. When the attackers spawn, they will usually follow these paths, looking towards their enemy. You know, unless something gets them turned around randomly or distracted by a teammate, or maybe they've been tilted to be on high alert. This creates for us small safe spaces all over the area, where if you have to be decloaked and not disguised, you could stand there for quite some time before somebody notices. And if you are noticed, it may give you time to react or escape. If you have to cross the travel paths, keep in mind that because of all the times the enemies randomly spawn in, and how many sets of eyes there could be on the area at any one time, there is a high chance that if you are in these areas, and uncloaked or undisguised, you will get spotted. In some cases, not even the disguise will help, so either be invisible or have a dead ringer charged and ready to use. All of this gets drilled into you the more you play spy, and the more that you keep dying in these areas because you were not careful. The experience that you earned is what leads enemies to ask the question, why is a spy so lucky? So let's take a look at this in practice. I'll keep a running percentage on the bottom of the screen, letting you know how dangerous I think I am where I'm standing. Let's make 5% being the lowest, because you know you could die from anything random in any spot, with 100 being the most dangerous and most risky to be at that spot. Try to notice in the clip when I'm in one of the 100% areas and not being cloaked or disguised, and see how fast I try and nope out of those situations. So remember, these numbers, they're not how much danger I'm in. They are a number of how likely I believe I'm going to be spotted if I was standing in those spots without a disguise and without any cloak up. So sometimes you'll see me hanging out in high percentage areas, but I'll be under a disguise, like right now. I think they might actually be believing me. Heck, I'm overhealed. Let's go. A few less eyes up this side. But let's get in behind them. Staying in close to this wall because I know if I swing out to the left, I'm going to be spotted by more people. Ah, that soldier saw something. He looked back this way. But he got distracted by a teammate. Right by their spawns here, but if I stay close to the side here, my chances of not being seen are low. Oh, that was a fail. Good thing I had an overheal from the kunai then. Managed to get away. They're checking for spy. But I'm on a cloak and dagger today, so I can hang out here a while. Now, my health is low. I'm switching up to a sniper disguise, which might be a bit more believable here. I'm hoping to see someone come out of their spawn on my left, so I can get a stab. That scout was looking for me. So like I said, you have a low percentage of being seen if you're standing there, so long as the enemy team's not distracted or not on tilt. Here we go, this pyro will heal us. After I stabbed this pyro, I saw there was little chance. I was in a very high danger zone, so I noped out of it. I'm gonna sap the sentry, and then I expect the engineer to come up here. There he is, but he's being chased by our pyro. I'll release him. I don't want to drop down. Fortunately, a sniper was chasing our pyro. That other spy's got the right idea. Shooting from up here is pretty safe. As long as you're not right in the middle where the snipers can see. That's why there's such a high percentage here. Snipers, man. Always watching. Always finding us spies. Teleporter. No, we can't allow that, so let's decloak where it's safe. Go into danger. That pyro was checking. see if we can get him. He's distracted now. They're all hanging out at that health pack. I'm just gonna hang out here. Wait until the crowd goes by. There go, the sniper's distracted. High visibility spot here, but because I'm under cloak, there's no problem. That pyro is hunting for spies. So while he's hunting, let's do this, but he sees it. Oh, and he gets the flare shot. Stop the burning. Hide. And yes, he gets... Oh, the spy gets pulled up into the sentry. That's an enemy spy. Calling out the spy for a teammate, but they don't see the call. Lower percentage down here because a lot of people don't actually push the payload underneath the tunnel. So many of them just run over the top and forget the objective. The longer I was making this video, the more I realized this is almost a graph of every time Mr. Paladin has died on this map and where I've died at. If you see 100% spot, I've probably died there 100 times. Oh, we get caught out. Now, how did we get spotted? Because we took an action on this soldier, and the demo man ahead reacted to the stab sound, and he saw me before we got back on the cloak. New round, new load up, but this time with a dead ringer. Now this time you'll see that I might even persist a little bit in the high danger or high visibility areas, even if I don't have a disguise. So go for this chain here. No disguise, because once I start taking damage, I'm gonna flash up the dead ringer that is already ready. I've got a nope out right now because it is not ready, and instantly go back in because it's ready to use. There we go, they spotted me. Hoping they don't hear the sound, it's very loud. So even while I'm in the safe spots, I take a little extra time to make sure nobody hears the dead ringer. So they're going into a high visibility area, but I had the ringer ready to get that follow-up stab on the heavy. Trying to get a bit of an overheal. Whoa, a blue medic. How did he get behind that sign? I didn't even know you could get there without falling off. He's a miracle worker. You'll see the engineers often building teleporters and dispensers in the same spots that I list as a 5% safety spot, because they just don't get seen. It's the same reason a spy wants to be there. The backside here is pretty safe. Not too many enemies go that way, staying with the payload. Spy is chasing me. Setting up for a matador. It was a safe spot to do it. You get a flash of 50% up here only because I'm behind that large rock, which cuts a lot of the enemy visibility. Especially the snipers that are in the spawn. Always got to think about those sniper lines, because even if they don't shoot you, they can call you out. Gerardi, just wait in the 5% zone while I'm waiting for it to wear off. I'm a scout, jumping around, using my disguise a little. Very risky stab on that pyro, but I thought he might have been chasing me down. Just missed the matador. Ooh, I thought for a moment I had him convinced. Sometimes when you're going towards the enemy, it's good to disguise as a friendly teammate disguise, just so they can trigger the ringer, but unfortunately there's no large ammo packs near the blue spawn on this map, so I didn't want to risk that. I spot the spy, I only get the butter knife, but it is good for the kill in the kill feed up the top. I see a sticky coming from a demo man, but going right up the middle, face to face bumping into a pyro. Sure way to get yourself checked. Fortunately, my ringer was ready. I get a bump there, so I nope out of that situation. Let's cycle around. Reset, try again. It's not always going to work all of the time. You got to keep pushing your luck. Keep pushing in on their edges. See what you can get away with. Again, another fail run. Let's reset. Do it again. Try a different way. Try a different disguise. Let's go up this way this time. I've got no disguise. I wait until I'm in a lower percent chance of being spotted before putting on a disguise. No one saw it. Different disguise. Scout, gotta jump around. Failure in a high percentage area, let's get out. Reset, try again. How do you get lucky? You keep trying and trying and trying until the luck works. That's how you get lucky. You're not lucky all the time. You've got to get prepared. And then you've got to try. Oh, he's going to get in range of the sentry gun, so hold that shot. There we go. Quick kill. I didn't want to just let the sentry gun kill him in case he took a little bit of damage and the sentry gun targets something else. I consider going for this medic here, and I call medic because my disguise was wounded, but when the heavy is spun up and shooting at a teammate, I've got to help the teammate out. The teammate can get the kill on the medic. Yep, definitely spotted. High risk area. High risk area, no cloak. I've got to get out of here to a safer spot. Now I'm safe, let's stab. Dead ringer is up. Oh, didn't see the scout. Thank you very much, soldier. Mission ends in 10 seconds. 50% spot to keep sapping this. I've got a lot of criticals. That engineer just exploded. It's like a super critical shot. Doesn't matter. Round is over. So let's try this. Different watch, different loadout, different map, same concept. This time we're using the kunai. Kunai and a latrangeur. Latrangeur? I don't know, people always fuss at me for the way I say it. Either way, it's three shots to a razorback to kill him. From a nice safe spot tucked behind their spawn. The only thing I'm really worried about there is if the enemy team sees me disguised around that corner. Okay, I'm overhealed from the kunai, I have a disguise. No problem to jump out here. Now this map has a vast difference to the other maps we've looked at, because even though there are walls and fences stopping shots, it does not stop visibility. So keep that in mind as I've got the numbers going up, that the numbers you are seeing is the numbers for the percent chance that I'm gonna be spotted if I do something. Nice safe spot here, I love that spot. Oh, forced down into the pit, but get rewarded with a heavy medic pair. I don't mind being down in this little gully. Not too many people can see you until you pop yourself back up. Oh, I got a bump there. Did they see it? No, they did not, and I'm disguised as an engineer. Heavy knew an engineer was here. Oh, got air blasted. See, the pyro saw it, but wasn't there in time to be able to get me. I love he extinguished the medic and then I stabbed him up. Oh, he hit the flare shot. Draw him towards my teammates. Is he chasing? I think I got away. Let's pick up this ammo over here because my cloak is low. There we go. Okay, I see a couple heavies. Let the pyro go by. Medic, sure, here's your medic right there. Medic in the back. Oh, here's this medic down here, this time with the soldier. No, there's no way out that way. You've got to come back this way. I'm surprised the heavy didn't gun him down a bit quicker than that. Okay, there's our heavies again. Oh, he's over in my safe space. This is going to be a nice, easy stab. Oh, wait. Engineer's carrying something even better than the heavy. Get the heavy. Oh, no. We get found out by the pyro in a high visibility area, and he hits random crits, so it's game over. My fellow spy, doing the right thing. So how can I relate to you guys how to get these numbers kind of ingrained into the way you move and the way you use your spy equipment? And I really can't. You've just got to experience it. You've got to find out where you keep dying and why you keep dying. And that'll let you work out the different sight lines of maps and where is safe and where is not safe. Even here, I was by their spawn, but it was a nice 10% spot. You know, very low chance that I was going to get killed there coming out of my cloak. Now, does that make it totally safe? No, it does not. There's an enemy pyro checking all around his spawn. Here we go, decloak. But look what happens. A pyro who happened to be running away from our heavy happens to see me. So there is no 100% safe spot. You're outside of your spawn, so there's a danger of dying. But do try and keep these things in mind while you're playing Spy. Thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors.
Non più dry farfalloni amoroso, notte giorno di torno girano, delle belle turbando a riposo, ma ci sento a doncino d'amor.